I'm out here on the trail on my way to go and work on it, and just came across Klipspringers standing right there. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. There it goes. Two of them. The third one will be around somewhere. Just probably out of sight. Okay, so I'm out here with a 4x2. And I have to go across the mountain there to reach the site where I'm working. I can't go through here with this, with the 4x2. And it's too much work to go out and get the 4x4. So I'm going to carry some of the equipment in. Not all of it, it's a bit too much. But I'll take at least the rake. I think I'll leave the shovel for now. I don't really need it out there now. I'll leave the chisels for now. I think I can do most of it with a hammer and the crow and the crowbar or the guala. So I'm gonna carry this in. Okay. About 20 minutes into the trail, and I just saw another two Klipspringer up there. I don't know if it's rarely four of them, usually one male, two female, but these are four big ones and the two groups are separate, so maybe there's another male involved. So there's probably some dispute over territory or mates. Anyway, I'm gonna leave the rake here because I want to rake up a clear path and continue with the rest of the equipment. But looking at the area over here, when I looked at it from the top, the other side, this area looked like it was going to be open up there. But it's not open enough. It's going to be easier to go up there and then cross over like I initially planned to do. So for now, I'm going to carry the rest of the hammer and the guala and the pick to where I will need it up there. I'll leave the rake here, but I'll come back and first do just move these rocks that will likely cause damage to tires. Just move them, clear the path, so that when I come tomorrow morning, I can actually drive through up to where I'm doing the rest of the work. So I'll do that. I'll carry that in now. So I have the crowbar and hammer and pick where I will, at the spot where I will probably need them for the first time. I'll probably be coming in this evening or this afternoon with a bike. I don't want to be moving equipment when I'm on the bike. This is the area that I'm looking at. I still have to go through to the next level up around here. Maybe continue straight. I will look at that a little bit later. For now, I'm just leaving these here. I'll come and get them later. Now I want to clear away just the rocks that just make it a smoother path from that hill up to here. Right, so looking at someone throwing some rocks around is going to be very boring. I've never really done video editing work, but I'll see if I can edit something to make it just a quick video. But the idea is now to move the bigger rocks to the side, but to not just throw them out of the way, but to actually mark the side of the track. So there we have the path cleared. You could easily drive over this, but it's really uncomfortable, and we have a well-defined path. It helps that each vehicle tracks in the same as the vehicle before it, so it helps that it's, you know, clearly defined like this. Okay, so back out of the trail. It's about 20 minutes of work, and about 45 minutes the total drive in and walk in and walk out and drive out. So the problem is, the further into the trail you get, the longer it takes you to get to that point for the next session of work. That's why I prefer to come in with a bike and I have the tools on the site already. But it's nice. I like it. Cheers. So on my way out of F Trail, I want to show you, this is a part of the trail that I particularly enjoy. It's not difficult, you don't need much clearance, you don't need a 4x4, but you have to get it exactly right, otherwise you have to stop, reverse to get your alignment right. So I have to almost touch the rocks on the right hand side, wait until the last moment to turn left so that I'm not touching the rocks on the left side, climb over them, then I have to get right next to this rock so that when I'm taking the turn on this one, I'm clearing this but not overshooting so that I catch that one in front. And this time I got it exactly right. Sometimes I just go too far or just turn too short, and it's every time you turn, it's from lock on one side to steering lock on the other side. Anyway, I just enjoy that part.